Hey everyone, today we'll talk about Control IQ technology. What is it, what's new about it, and everything you need to know before starting your Control IQ training. I'm Levi, this is Between Two Lines. If you use a Tandem insulin pump and you use a Dexcom continuous glucose monitor, you're probably aware that the Control IQ update has come out. Similar to the update that came out on the basal, it will work with you to help keep your blood sugar between the lines, increase the amount of time you spend in range. If you're considering doing the Control IQ training and update, or maybe you haven't, or maybe it's just not coming on your radar, this is an excellent video to watch as a crash course to provide you with expectations on what will happen during the training and avoid some of the time-consuming bits I went through. Part of what I noticed during the training is that it's a lot of what followed by how. And they include it in each break, and I found myself re-watching the same clips because it took me the entire clip to figure out what they were telling me was going to happen. And then I spent re-watching it again to figure out how it worked. So in this video, I'm going to focus in on a lot of the what. What are the features of Control IQ? That way, when you watch the training, you can focus more in on the details on the how. And I think it'll make it a much more beneficial piece of training and a lot less scratch your head. On a side note, if you're like me, I was super interested in a Control IQ technology and I was very excited to the update. Even with all that said, man, 10 seconds in, I was a zombie. It just puts me to sleep. I zoned out. So hopefully this will help give you some guidelines on what's going to happen during the video so that you can pace yourself mentally and you get the most out of it. In a nutshell, Control IQ technology will work with you to keep your blood sugar within range by administering insulin or withholding insulin as needed. It's not going to manage your diabetes for you, and it's going to require a lot of fine tuning on your part to perform at its highest capacity, but I'm very excited about the potential that it has for you guys and for me as well. So here's the skeleton of what Control IQ will do. If your blood sugar, and you've got to have both the Dexcom CGM and you've also got to use a Tandem pump, but when those two things are linked together, when it sees your readings show that you're on your way down and you are gonna hit 112.5 milligrams per deciliter in the next 30 minutes, it will start to scale back your basal level. If you continue to drop and it sees that you're gonna get below 70 in the next 30 minutes, it will discontinue your basal level altogether. Once you've already gone low and treated, your blood sugar starts to rise back up. Previously, with the basal IQ technology, the moment your blood sugar started to rise, it resumed basal rate. This one's gonna work a little bit different. It's a little bit more fine-tuned. Your blood sugar can start coming back up, still no basal rate. When it sees that your blood sugar is gonna hit 70 in the next 30 minutes, it will then start reincorporating your basal rate at a reduced capacity. Not until you hit 70 on your way back up will it introduce full basal rate. Now let's look at the other end of the spectrum. If you're on your way up, you're gonna have a high blood sugar. If your continuous glucose monitor provides the readings and your pump interprets that you're gonna be above 160 in the next 30 minutes, it will increase your basal rate. It's gonna increase your basal rate, and if you continue, let's say you're skyrocketing and the increased basal rate is not gonna cut it, there's a limitation to how high it will go, and that's covered in the training. But let's say it says it's not gonna cover it, it can then introduce a correction bolus on top of the basal rate. So if you're going up fast enough, it will give you a lump of insulin to try to get you back under control. I can tell you what it's not gonna do is allow you to skip boluses on your meals, and it's just gonna put you back together and manage it for you. You've gotta have your own control first. It is just a tool in your bag. So now's the point I wanna stop and give you feedback that I picked up during the training episodes. There's a lot going on here. Your pump's gonna start giving you extra insulin. It's gonna do correction boluses. It's gonna withhold insulin on your way down. It's gonna suspend your basal rates on the way down. All of that activity is based off of your profile you have built into your pump. You have to have an accurate profile in your pump or none of it's going to work right. Doesn't sound like that big of a deal. It's a big deal. If you're like me, and I told you I'll always be straightforward on this series. My profile is not that great. In fact, it's better now than it ever has been, but I used to just wear the watch, always see what my blood sugar was, and just give little bits here and there. I wasn't even putting in the blood sugar levels for the correction factor. I was just saying I ate 15 grams of carbs or I ate 20. I was just giving little boluses to get my blood sugar under control. And I could put some pretty good numbers up that way. And that was when I first got the pump. That will not cut it with this technology. You've got to use the pump the way it was designed and work with your healthcare provider to dial in your basal rate, dial in your correction factor, because this Control IQ technology is going to use all of that to automatically start making adjustments. And if your profile is out of whack, like mine was, this is going to jack you all up. It's as an encouragement. These things are becoming available to us, these hybrid looping processes, and it's exciting, but you're not just going to be able to walk in the door and reap all the benefits from it. You're going to have to put in the legwork first to get your profile dialed in. Okay, so right back to it. There's additional two settings you can have with Control IQ. One of them is sleep and one of them is exercise mode. Sleep mode, well, they're both pretty interesting. The sleep mode I thought was really cool. The chapter on sleep mode will provide you a lot of information on how to set it up, how to fine tune it, the different ways to initiate it. But here's the gist of it. If your profile is accurate, the ones you put in with your doctor, the sleep portion of the Control IQ technology can keep your blood sugar between 100 and 120 throughout the night. If you or me, that's the most exciting part about this entire thing. If I can keep my blood sugar between 100 and 120 all night, oh my goodness, that'd be worth it. It's weight in gold right there, because I've got all these kind of phantom blood sugar rising at 3 o'clock in the morning when it was level for the previous 6 hours. I got dawn phenomenon horribly. The moment I wake up, it's skyrocketing. All these things during sleep mode, it's gonna be a little tighter parameters to keep you within that range. It's gonna withhold insulin or administer insulin earlier to keep you within 100 and 120. That should be extremely valuable for a lot of people out there. The second mode is exercise mode, which is equally as cool. So exercise is obvious, fitness, working out, running. It's going to be any kind of high level of activity. It could be any kind of sport. For me, I'm going to put it in exercise mode when I'm mowing the lawn. The purpose of exercise mode is to be a little more sensitive to the fact that you're using a lot of energy and could go low. It's to help avoid hypos. If you're exercising, working out, mowing the lawn, whatever, and you're on your way down, when the continuous glucose monitor shows that you're going to be at 140 in the next 30 minutes, it's gonna slow down your basal rate. It's gonna decrease basal rate. If you continue to fall and it shows you're gonna hit 80 in the next 30 minutes, it's gonna suspend basal rate. So a little more aggressive with cutting back on the basal rate to avoid going low during working out or the football game or any heavy activity you may be doing on a day-to-day basis. So all in all, it's an exciting time to be using the Tandem pump and the Dexcom CGM. Control IQ technology is a really, really neat thing that I'm excited about. This process of introducing the loops and the hybrid loops to type 1 diabetics is huge. The quality of life could go dramatically higher with tools like this. But I want to reiterate, as you start the Control IQ part of your journey, you've got to be in control of your profile. You can't be Levi. I've spent a lot of time being a bad diabetic. I spent a lot of time being a horrible diabetic. And even when I started doing things better and had a continuous glucose monitor and insulin pump, having a crap profile where you're constantly just winging it like I was, this will not work. So first step, get dialed in with your healthcare professionals. Put the time in to figure out what your correction factor is. Put the time in to figure out what the correct basal rate's gonna be, etc. And then this Control IQ will do wonders for you. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope that you got something out of it. If you watched it to this point, you were very aware that I'm not an expert on the matter. But I did try to provide some of my input and my experience with the Control IQ I've had thus far. Please leave in the comments what yours has been, any advice you have. Please don't make the mistake of thinking these videos are just for me making it for others. I get so much out of the feedback that is not only motivating but educating. So please leave in the comments something that you've experienced with Control IQ, because it's going to help me dial mine in as well as others who will see it. My name is Levi. This is Between the Lines.